So this is Chaos Legend again. So this is just me playing against a non-Heirloom deck in the casual room. Just a classic game. So I'm playing my my Vettelkin Affinity deck. it's pretty fun. Anyway, you know, most of the Affinity cards are banned, but there's a few in there that I never got much attention because aggro affinity was always so much better at taking people down to zero. And some of my favorite cards that got left over by that process are still legal. So. Anyway. Alright, so we got Jeweled Amulets, Fire Golem, Talisman of Dominance, Aether Spell Bomb, Business Bobble. Solid enough hand. So keep that. So Vettelkin Archmage is one of the engines of the deck. The deck can win without him, but if you go off with him, he could be pretty insane. Start casting these zero casting ghost artifacts and drawing the whole deck out. Yeah, I forgot to target my opponent because I was playing this deck solitaire before. Alright, so I gotta think about what I wanna cast here. Probably just a couple of talismans here. Force spike his crystal ball. Slow down his ability to fix the card drawing in his deck. So I'll just drop the Archmage. He's playing blue white. Chances are Archmage won't be killed, although he could always oblivion on it. But we'll get at least one card off the dealer. And there's another Archmage. Has some kind of Eldrazi cards. It'll be. Oh no, he hasn't dropped that yet. Just column my depth soon. Tectonic Edge won't find a target. So there's another Crystal Ball. He really seems to like that card. So here we'll drop a second Archmage and then play Spire Golem for 2 mana. Draw 2 cards. That's it for this turn.
Now is the time.
Here's, yeah, Eldrazi Temple. There's some kind of Eldrazi in here. Pop it with 2. I can drop Esper Zora. That'll give us at least 2 cards to turn. Yeah, we'll draw another 2. Sigil Distinction for 0. Draw another 2. I can always just pick this up later if I want to use it to beat them. Talisman of Progress. And then I'm just gonna. I could play more, but full hand. And next turn I should be able to draw my whole deck and then bounce all his permanents for everything if he doesn't, you know, interrupt me. So it goes to Oblivion Ring my Esper Zora for some reason. It's fine. I don't know why. Wouldn't Oblivion Ring the Archmage Zora. Maybe can't deal with beat them. Hoping I ran out of artifacts and then pump up all my jeweled amulets for a ton of mana this turn. I should have played the other Archmage first. Then. Two is returning. back to stop your release. Drop that second archmage. It looks like we could run out of artifacts. I also want to have enough spells cast without decking ourselves there to be able to storm it up without dying next turn. So there's our finisher or game locking card, which is Temporal Fissure, which can't really be countered. Because storm copies when you play the spell, not when it resolves. At this point I can just play my whole deck out. So I left 6 cards in my library, and then Storm. So just Storm everything, right? All of his permanents. That's what 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 copies of Temporal Fissure. Return my archmages just to give myself more time, right? I don't deck myself but playing artifacts out. It's pretty much game. So not a whole lot you can do there, and that was turn 6. So pretty fast. And you don't need expensive cards to do dumb things in Magic, that's for sure. Alright, so I'll see you guys. Next video, and talk to you later.